The Devonian period, a time when the first forests emerged and the earliest vertebrates colonized land. While life on land was still in its infancy, life in the seas was diverse and booming. The Devonian period is sometimes called the Age of Fishes because of the diverse, abundant, and in some cases, bizarre types of creatures that swam in Devonian oceans. Among these bizarre beasts were a group of diverse and sometimes frightening fish called Placoderms. The most notorious of these armored fish was none other than the Dunkleosteus. In this video, we will focus on the largest and most well-known species, Dunkleosteus torelli, and we will learn more about how it lived, as well as what animals they shared the Devonian seas with. Enjoy! Fossils of Dunkleosteus torelli were first discovered by amateur paleontologist J. Terrell and his son in 1867. They were found along the Lake Erie cliffs at the town of Sheffield Lake, Ohio. He called this animal terrible fish. This animal was rediscovered by paleontologist David Dunkel and was named Dunkleosteus in 1956 in his honor. The type species was named D. torelli in honor of the original discoverer, J. Terrell. Placoderms lived from the Silurian to the end of the Devonian period, from about 430 to 358 million years ago. The placoderms were among the first jawed fish, and their lower jaws are believed to have evolved from their first gill arches. Placoderms are thought to be paraphyletic, made of several distinct outgroups or sister taxa to all living jawed vertebrates, which originated among their ranks. This means that placoderms are likely the ancestors of all tetrapods, from sharks to dinosaurs and even people. This is illustrated by a Chinese placoderm, Entelognathus, which dates to 419 million years. Entelognathus is the only known placoderm with a bony jaw similar to modern bony fishes, and is the earliest example of dermal marginal jawbones we see in modern-day tetrapods. Placoderms were also the first fish to develop pelvic fins, the precursor to hind limbs of tetrapods. They were also the first to possess true teeth, which evolved from scales. Dunkleosteus torelli lived around 360 million years ago during the Late Devonian. It belongs to an order of placoderms known as the arthrodires, and was the largest and deadliest member of these animals. This species grew up to 8.9 meters or 28.8 feet and weighed an estimated 4 tons or 4.4 short tons. Instead of teeth, Dunkleosteus had a set of bony plates that sliced past each other in the jaws. The animal's bite incorporated connections between the skull, the thoracic shield, the lower jaw, and the jaw muscles, joined together by movable joints. This resulted in both a high speed of jaw opening and an incredibly powerful bite. D. torelli could open their jaws in 20 milliseconds and complete the whole process in 50 to 60 milliseconds. The animal's bite could exert a force of 6,000 to 7,400 newtons when its blades closed down on its prey. Such a powerful bite suggests that Dunkleosteus had no trouble eating shelled or armored animals, such as ammonites and other placoderms. Fossil evidence shows that these animals would have also put their powerful bite to good use against other members of the same species. Bite marks have been found on fossilized armored plates, showing evidence of repeated bites to crack the victim's armor. These bites were often found near the joints and gaps of the armor towards the back of the skull, further indicating that they were targeted attacks. Dunkleosteus and other placoderms are believed to have given birth to live young. This is evidenced by the Australian genus Materpisces. A remarkably well-preserved fossil of this animal was discovered with an unborn embryo and even an umbilical cord still present. Dunkleosteus torelli may have also given birth in nurseries similar to modern-day sharks. Devonian nursery sites like Strad in Belgium and Waterloo Farm in South Africa show that several placoderm families would gather in shallow estuaries and even freshwater systems to breed. This way, the young could grow up safe from predators and other adult Dunkleosteus. Dunkleosteus tyreli are primarily found in the upper Cleveland member of the Ohio Shale, roughly 360 million years ago, during the upper Faminian stage of the late Devonian. The site represents a shallow water community, and Dunkleosteus itself is known to have lived with other huge and varied arthrodires. Take Bungaridus, for example. Bungaridus was a smaller, cleaver-headed placoderm with a unique hunting style. Its curved dental region suggests that these animals would use their jaws to chop their prey up like an axe. Titanicthes was a large placoderm that was almost the same size as a Dunkleosteus. However, while Dunkleosteus was a macro predator, Titanicthes was actually a suspension feeder, similar to modern-day whale sharks. Titanicthes is one of the earliest vertebrates to show evidence of filter feeding, and only adds to the interesting diversity of placoderms. Of course, placoderms weren't the only fish around. Sharks, like Cladozoalachi, were already reaching 2 meters in length and made efficient, fast-moving hunters. Cladozoalachi is one of the best-known early sharks thanks to well-preserved fossils. In addition to the skeleton, the fossils were so well-preserved that they included traces of skin, muscle fibers, and internal organs, such as the kidneys. Even the last meals of these sharks have been preserved, showing a diet of small bony fish, arthropods, and protovertebrates. However, it would still be a while before sharks became the dominant predators of the seas. The oceans belonged to the placoderms until the end of the Devonian. Unfortunately, the reign of Dunkleosteus and all the other placoderms came to an end during the late Devonian mass extinction. Several hypotheses have been proposed for the extinction event, including volcanic activity, volatile plate tectonics, global oxygen shortages, climate change, and even asteroids. Another interesting possibility is a Devonian plant hypothesis. The hypothesis states that it was the arrival and widespread progression of terrestrial plants that triggered the mass extinction events. The spread of Archaeopteryx forests would have led to faster soil development, which would in turn lead to faster silicate weathering. This process creates calcium and magnesium carbonates, which in turn remove CO2 from the atmosphere. These compounds would then make their way into rivers and then the seas, where they would become buried in marine sediments, further lowering CO2 levels. The loss of this greenhouse gas would have then contributed to widespread global cooling, causing drastic climate fluctuations. In an ironic twist of fate, the expansion of life on land may have caused havoc on the oceans, from which life first arose. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing and sharing the video. Be sure to post in the comments below which animal featured in this video is your favorite. And if you'd like to stay up to date on all our latest projects, you can do so by following our social media or joining our Discord. You can also support the channel on Patreon and get some neat rewards in return, including early access to videos, digital artwork bundles, exclusive merchandise, and more. Of course, pledging to Patreon is not at all expected, and just watching the video helps tremendously. So, as always, thank you for watching.